As we look towards an uncertain future, it is impossible to know where things are headed without looking back at the past. And for the Gaza Strip, conflict is ingrained in its history, going back generations beyond the days of the Ottoman Empire to British rule from 1918 to Egypt in 1948. And remember that year, because around that same time, as Gaza came under Egyptian rule, Israel was proclaiming statehood. And for 20 years, tension grew until an all-out war broke between Israel and its Arab neighbors. After the Six-Day War in 1967, Gaza was seized by Israel.
A strong, fortified position. To take it, the infantry were closely supported by air power.
And then there is the odd case of violent history repeating itself almost 50 days to the day from this weekend's surprise attack. Invading forces from Egypt and Syria caught Israel off guard in what's known as the Yom Kippur War.
During the fire mission, Syrian MiGs attacked. They came in low, their cannons blazing. The troops here fired back with machine guns and small arms. Israeli Phantom jets intercepted. The sky was a confusion of warplanes. The MiGs dodging, the Phantoms maneuvering for a position to launch missiles.
Meanwhile, in Gaza, outrage over Israeli occupation grew, and the first intifada, meaning rebellion, began, followed by the second after a breakdown in talks for peace. Hamas, a Palestinian militant group, came to Gaza in 2006. That's when they came into power in the last election there to date. And although Israel seemingly gave up control of the Gaza Strip in 2007 internally, it instituted a land and sea blockade of that small strip the size of Washington, D.C., arguing it was protecting the Israeli state. Now, a year later, intense fighting broke out once again.
About 80 Israeli warplanes dropped 100 bombs on Gaza today. The Air Force released this cockpit video. More than 220 Palestinians killed, hundreds wounded, many critically. It isn't clear yet how many civilians are among the casualties. No time for ambulances. The wounded were carried on corrugated iron in private cars. Militiamen fired rockets at Israeli towns. Israelis ran for cover throughout the day and were told to stay close to home. But one rocket scored a direct hit, killing an Israeli man in the small town of Netivot.
And since then, Gaza's unemployment rate is now among the highest in the world. Around 95% of the population does not have access to clean water. Electricity is limited. Food is often scarce. And the UN estimates that 80% of the population must rely on international aid to survive. Options to leave are also nearly impossible for those who live there. And nearly half of the people who live in Gaza are children. Tonight, Gaza is surrounded by the Israeli Defense Forces and under total siege, meaning Gaza would receive no electricity, no food, no water, no fuel. And Israel says the siege is in retaliation for that surprise attack by Hamas fighters. And a top Hamas commander says his forces attacked Israel in part because of a recent Israeli raid around the Al-Aqsa Mosque, one of the holiest sites in Islam. And right now, as both sides look at the conflict, they are met with images like this. Death, fear, destruction, and hate.
Thanks for watching. Stay updated about breaking news and top stories on the NBC News app or follow us on social media.